Okay, video three on this Saturday, April 6, 2019. It's 9:31 a.m. Pacific time. Okay, so my first video was praising God and giving Him glory. My second video I just did was on Proverbs 6, and I hadn't planned on it, but this is how the Lord works if you will let Him lead you, in my opinion. And I don't, I'm not telling you how to do things, okay? Really, I'm not telling you how to believe. I'm not telling you. I'm just sharing with you, sowing some seeds here. And wow, the last video was human trafficking. Started out on Proverbs 6, read the whole thing, and then the Lord led me to pray about human trafficking. So I'm gonna read in John 6 now. And I don't know, I didn't pre-plan this. So after these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him because they saw, church, are you listening? Because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. And I know that a lot of churches won't get into believing and praying for miracles because, well, I'm not telling you what I know, but yes, I am. I'm going to tell you what I believe, okay? But I believe that because we don't live on miracles, we live by faith in God and faith on God. But He did give us miracles. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So a great multitude followed him because they saw. Why would we not want to follow the pattern that Jesus Christ set out for us? Because it gets shot down by media, and they make fun of, Benny Hinn. And I haven't really watched him in a long time, but I have watched him. And they put a twist on them, and it's just like, okay, he's doing it for the money. And they accuse preachers, TV evangelists of all this crap. And that's why churches, some of the reasons churches don't get into this and don't, but I mean, oh, okay, a church would rather have a circus at their church instead of try and believe for miracles for people and let that draw people to their church or whatever. You know what I mean? I'd rather have ponies and a circus out there for the kids, instead of doing the work of God and letting God draw the people by His Holy Spirit. It says, not by might, not by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. That's why I'm not worried if I only get one or two viewers on these things. I'm not gonna hype you. As you notice, I don't hype myself, and maybe I should. Maybe I should, because I'm not making a living at this. But you know what? The Lord said, they who preach the gospel shall live by the gospel. So I'm living quite nice. I don't have my own home, and I have more than this as a responsibility, night and day, 24/7. And I don't get paid for that too, but God is taking care of me. Okay? And I'm not going to complain about how He's doing it. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Cast thy care upon him, and he will care for you. Now, see, I didn't even get started very far, and I got into preaching. Sorry, whatever. After these, I'll start over again. John 6. After these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, and there really is a Sea of Galilee, I believe, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him, Jesus Christ, because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. And Lord, I pray right now that you would do miracles on people. This is real, Lord. People are suffering out there, and I know somebody that is just as healthy as can be could be looking at this. One or two people, not a thing wrong with you. So I pray beyond this. I pray out there. if we pray more and more, maybe we wouldn't even need such a big health care system. Do you know what I'm saying? We would do our job, church, on them that were diseased. And Jesus went up into a mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. And the Passover, a feast of the Jews, was nigh. When Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Peter, unto Philip, Whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. He knew he was getting ready to do a miracle. I mean, we just read about him doing miracles, and people, multitudes followed him because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. So now he's got this group of people, and they're hungry. And this he said, Philip asked, how can we feed all these people? And this he said to prove him, when Jesus lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he saith unto Philip, Whence shall we buy bread that these may eat? You know, and And this he said to prove him, for he himself knew what he would do. And you know what? He knows what he's going to do in and through our lives too. And he's here proving us. Are we going to have faith in him or what? Philip answered him, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, saith unto him, There is a lad here which hath 5 barley loaves and 2 small fishes, but what are they among so many? And Jesus said, Make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down in number about 5,000. Wow, 5,000 men. And Jesus, and I suppose, I think in other chapters, there books, there's men and beside the women and the children. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, Gather up the fragments that remain, that nothing be lost. I'm going to stop right there, because this is getting long enough, and this is a long chapter. Okay. Got a lot more you can just read and meditate on in there. This is why we can pray and intercede for people to be fed and God get people off the streets, come against homelessness. You can intercede, actually. You can pray these prayers because the heart of God is that people would be fed. Okay. You know, wake up, church. You know, God, increase our faith, so that we can intercede and so that people can be saved. They can live long enough on this earth to be saved and go to heaven and then have a great life. You know, I think we are just not even living. We're just living in a minute life more abundant. He gives us life and life more abundant, but we're just living a minute amount of the life that he has for us and our fellow humans on this earth. So we can pray about what's missing, intercede, use our faith to intercede for other people. Sometimes I know I'm not the only intercessor here on this earth, and I know I'm not the only prayer warrior, and many people, you know, I'm not criticizing anybody for not. Some people, they are, you know, it's just like AOC is expecting everybody to be able to be, yeah, everybody can be a billionaire, but we do need these people. Not everybody can be a congressman at the same time in America. And I understand where she's coming from. Yeah, it's okay to be a waitress and a bartender. I've been there, done that. I've been there, done all those things she talks about. I wasn't a bartender, but I worked in a restaurant for 4 years that had a bar, a dinner house, beautiful, wonderful. Italian dinner house in the mountains, Siskiyou Mountains of Oregon, where there was a bar, okay, with a bartender, with bartenders, and we served wine, okay, and drinks, okay. But I served food. I was a waitress. Before that, I was a waitress for my parents in their restaurant, starting in 8th grade. So AOC, God bless her, but man, I pray for her right now. Let's just pray for her. We bind the devil from her, and I'm not, please don't attack her like she's, got the devil on her and in her. Everybody is success. You know what I'm trying to say, that word. We're all susceptible. Oh God, I gotta find that word and be able to say that word. To be, because the devil's out there, okay? Don't make it a big, horrible, like, oh, spooky thing. We're just brainwashed. We're just brain, even the church is brainwashed. We don't even use our abilities, like our potential. To bind the devil off of people. I lift her up to you, Lord. I lift up this girl to you. I'm just going to pray from a pure heart. You love her, Lord. Man, you ever get a hold of her, Lord, and she come to the right side? I mean, the correct side, okay? I'm not making her into a, anything beyond extremism. In extremism, I'm not talking about that, but when she starts thinking right, if she starts thinking right, can you imagine? So let's don't give up on her, because she's just, she's something else, okay? Let's pray for her. Let's pray for her. God, open her eyes. Even this day, I think actually, and I'm talking and praying at the same time, I think actually she's getting some pushback and she's calming down a little bit, acting more, even though she's eating the popcorn and, putting her IKEA furniture together. I think she's actually, God's touch her, Lord. She's actually starting to possibly be woke. I know it might not look like it, but I'm going to pray she does. And then I pray, Father, that you touch Nancy Pelosi. Because Nancy Pelosi is even, she's not, she's pushing back, I think. She's like, something's happening. We lift up the Democrats to you. Let's just pray over the Democrats and the Republicans. I'm not no respecter of persons. Yeah, I have a side. But, I've seen some things on the GOP side too that were totally not right, in my opinion. Now we're all growing up, we're all learning, and there's some vicious people out there, mostly on the left, mostly liberals, and yet God loves them too. Father, touch them, bless them, wake us up, wake us all up. That just be a non-biased prayer for all of us. And if you watch my videos, you'll see that I pray over everybody and all kinds of people, all peoples, even the Muslims. We lift them up to you, Lord. It's our thinking about things. Some people might look at me and go, I was called grandma twice this week in a derogatory way. I'm proud to be a grandmother, okay? And it's none of your business, but I might have a Hispanic grandchild. And you know what? You leave my family alone and out of this. You evil doers. You know what? I come against this targeting, this doxing bullcrap. This is one of the meanest, most vilest, wickedest thing that has come about in this whole thing. This whole political thing. And I'm going to curse it at the root. I bind it and I curse it at the root. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. No more. No more ever again in the entire world. You don't target personal people's lives. Okay? Because that's where the extremists can go and they can personally hurt people. And we bind that too in Jesus' name. We bind extremism. And we bind extremism and we bind shadow banning, even with the big tech companies, Google, Microsoft. I don't know, I'm not blaming anybody, but I'll put them in there, Twitter and Facebook, Instagram, whatever, that they will stop being political and stop being cheaters and stealers and shadow banning and the algorithms. We curse the algorithms at the root. That's where they go behind the scenes and the technology is manipulated to go one way or another. Oh yeah, I'm catching on. And I pray against the evil behind all of it. Because that in itself is being prejudiced. Okay, I don't want these things to happen to any side. I wouldn't want what happened to our president, President Trump, to a Democrat or any other side. Okay? I wouldn't want it. It would be evil and mean and vile and vicious. And I do pray for Barr, who was appointed. Every attorney general is appointed by the president. Okay? So, I pray for William Barr that you would raise up an investigation on the people that did this to our president. President Trump, who was a businessman, who was living his life and decided to run for president and decided to run on the GOP ticket. And I believe what happened to him would have happened to any one of the GOP presidents. I believe what happened to him went beyond even his... This started with the Obama administration, I believe with all my heart. If it started in the Oval Office, if it did, if it started in the Oval Office or wherever, if it did, I pray for an investigation. And I pray that you would uproot this. I pray that you'll bring this to the light. And those that are guilty, period. They will be investigated and prosecuted. And that this will never, ever happen. And that this will be put in the history books for public education. No, this is not going to be covered up, people. This is not going to be covered up. God's not going to allow it to be covered up. And then that you just bring back America and really, truly make America great again. And that our CIA and our NSA, FBI, and all of the intelligence don't have to be afraid of me, people. If you're watching, I bind a devil from you. In Jesus' name, don't stop your lying. Stop your lying. Warning, warning, warning. Stop your lying. God, you're doing it. You're not doing it to man. You're doing it to God, and it's dangerous. Okay, so be delivered. I thank God for you. I pray for you to be safe. I've always prayed for the CIA, the FBI. I've prayed for you for many years. We pray for our law enforcement to be safe. And then, so for you people, whoever was involved, not accusing anybody, but whosoever was involved in all of this horror, hell, done to an elected president of the United States of America, that God would convict you and that you will repent and you will even come forth. And God protect the whistleblowers. God protect the whistleblowers. In Jesus' name. And thank you for watching. Thank you for coming in agreement. Whosoever of you that believe in this prayer or any part of it. If you don't believe it, fine. You don't say your amens. Don't lie to God and say you say your amen and you don't really mean it. God's not into phony, okay? And God touched the church and bring down the walls of the church between the blacks and the whites and the Asians. And yeah, we have our own culture. And we thank God for the culture of each and every person and group. And you know, I don't want to leave out the Muslims, because I was going to say it's what we're taught and what we believe. And maybe there's some stuff even in the church that needs to be uprooted, some old stuff, bad stuff, mindsets. And I'm not talking about the real stuff here. Don't get me wrong. I'm not coming against you. I'm not coming against anything that is of God. Okay? But refresh and redo your church, Lord. And get them ready for the great harvest. Because there's got to be a great harvest. And the Bible talks about a falling away. Maybe the falling away has already happened long ago. I mean, think about it. We have been so brainwashed in so many ways, in so many areas, even in the church. Just think about what could be, would be. Maybe the falling away has already happened. And now God can uproot all the bad. I'm not talking about TV evangelists, so don't target those people. Thank God the gospel is being preached from the satellite TVs into areas where no man could possibly ever go as an evangelist. Okay? Stop it. Stop it. We can all work together here. There's room for all of us. There is room for all of us. I'm not nonprofit. I am not nonprofit on purpose so that I can speak politically. But if you want to help me out, you can go over to newsandprayer.com and give a dollar a month even. I'm not going to beg you for it, because that's not what I get on here for. I just want to keep talking, okay? All right, and it would be nice to have my needs met. But my needs are met, with or without you. And I'm not a man pleaser, so anybody that were to give to me, I can't go and, you know, I can't be a man pleaser, okay? We need to stop being men pleasers in the church, okay? We need to give up our church if God can't sustain it. Don't use the widows for their money. You're supposed to be helping the widows. Yeah, they got money, some of them. But the ones, you know, don't, you know, make sure you're dealing with somebody that's okay, that doesn't have Alzheimer's, mental illness, dementia, and they don't know what they're doing when they put their money in your, you know. Make sure you're caring for them, and you're a small enough or large enough church that you can have somebody talk with people, get to know them. People are tired of the same old, cultish type stuff in the church, a cult type atmosphere. I break it in the name of Jesus. And those people that don't have a church to go to, God bless you. You are part of the church. You are a part of God's church. And it's time that we stop demonizing these people and shaming them because they're not plugged in. Okay? I'm sorry. But I thank God that I'm so free that I can say whatever God wants me to say. And that people will be set free to actually really know Him. Not just go to church every Sunday and sit in a pew and pretend that you're all right, and yet you're not, and you might even be going to hell. Okay? God is love, and He loves you. And the joy of the Lord is our strength, and His peace and mercy and grace is abundant, and His grace is sufficient. Wherever you're at in life, always know that He, the God of the entire world, has always provided for us. If you look back and go, well, I only had an apple last week to eat. Well, you're still alive, right? Be thankful for that apple and start thanking Him for meeting your needs. Thank Him for giving you the strength to endure, the patience. And I better just stop now because I could go on and on and on. And this is 26 minutes long. So have a really good day and life, and God bless you. Thank you so much for coming in agreement if you do. And have a good day. Bye-bye.